Oh, everything's all set for reception.
Oh, I don't know who's more nervous, me or Madge.
Sure, you'll manage admirably. Oh, excuse me.
Harold. Oh, you seem rather tense. That's understandable, I suppose.
No, on the contrary, Mrs. Ramsay, I'm rearing to go.
Oh, get off with this, Mrs. Ramsay. The name's Edna, but I would like a quiet word with you before the service.
Oh.
I'm sorry Dan couldn't be here. You know how keen he's always been for you two to get on with it. But this is a mother talking. You look after my girl. So help me if you turn into another Fred.
Mrs. Ramsay.
You have shilly-shallied and kept the poor girl dangling long enough. That's a lot of lost time to account for.
Your point has been registered.
Good. How about that? We've had the sermon and we didn't even have to go inside. I reckon you'll do me as a son-in-law.
Here they come.
Will you all be seated, please? We come here together in the sight of God and in the presence of this congregation to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable state of life instituted from the beginning of God Himself and signifying to us the spiritual union between Christ and His church. Do you, Harold Wayne Bishop, take this woman, Margaret Mary Ramsay, to be your lawful wife? Will you love her, cherish her, honor and protect her in sickness and in health, and, forsaking all others, keep you only unto her for as long as ye both shall live?
I will.
And forsaking all others, keep you only unto him for as long as ye both shall live.
I will.
With this ring I wed you. With my body I worship you. With all that I am and all that I have, I honor you.
By the giving and receiving of a ring, and by the joining of hands, I therefore declare them husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. You may now kiss the bride.